Some days are more difficult than others.
Natty, is everything all right?
There are times when my father's absence drifts to the back of my mind, and I feel peace for a day or two. But this is not one of those times. I miss him. I miss running with him. I miss Matibeliland. He should still be here. And it's my fault that he isn't.
It's not your fault, Natty. There's nothing you could have done to prevent it.
That is what my mother says. But he died protecting me. And I cannot help but feel guilty over that. I find myself reliving the moment more often than I would like. I believe I would feel less helpless if I could truly put an end to Harlow and the rest of Rookwood's miserable lot. Of course, you have put an end to Rookwood. And Ranrock. You've done a great deal of good that is a benefit to all. With Harlow on the prowl, there can be no real peace. Each day he remains free, he does more damage, leaving people like Archie Bickle to suffer the consequences.
I agree, Natty. We'll get him. I've never seen someone so committed to a cause.
Thank you. I believe we will get him. Thank you for speaking with me. It was very helpful.
Always frown! Peeves should burn the castle down!
I'm glad you came.
Sebastian, I received your owl. What's happened?
Ominous spoke with Anne about what happened with my Uncle Solomon. She believes I should pay for what I did, but she won't turn me in. She said the guilt I'll have to live with is punishment enough.
I'm so sorry, but I'm glad to know that you can at least try to move on now.
The thing is, I think I've lost my sister, my twin, forever. She refuses to even see me. I can't blame her. I couldn't really blame any of you if you gave up on me entirely. You all believed in me, and I let you all down.
Sebastian, I'm afraid Anne may never be able to forgive you. But at least now you have a chance to change your path.
I am glad for that. But I still have hopes that Anne may in time understand what happened and come to forgive me. I realize I can't undo what's been done, but I can try every day to make up for it. I owe you and Ominous everything for standing by me.
Well, it wasn't easy. But I believe in you, Sebastian. I've had a sense about you since that first day in Defense Against the Dark Arts.
Seems so long ago. Thank you. I have no idea what's to come, but I'm grateful for your friendship. I'm glad you came to Hogwarts.
These rocks have seen better days.
And you say they made it after you placed the moonstone?
Do you know why or what it means? Does it have to do with the Snidgets?
The breadth of one's knowledge can be as wide as the seas, and yet only run so deep.
It's good to see you again, Doran. Did Poppy tell you about everything that's happened?
She did, and I am glad to see that you are both safely returned. I did question the wisdom of sending you on a path at a time when that path was unknown at best, deadly at worst. But the acumen of the centaurs is neither personal nor partial. The skies tell us what is to come, and often we do not know what we have seen until it has come to pass.
You knew the poachers would try to kill Poppy and me.
I did not know, my young friend. But I shall say that I was not surprised. It was in much the same manner that I expected our first meeting.
I don't suppose you'd like to start from the beginning. I think Poppy and I could use that.
Of course. I find it is often the best place to start, is it not? Many, many moons ago, I divined a series of events. Their meaning long evaded me, until you brought news of the Snidgets and their poacher pursuers. I believe the symbol created by the Mooncalf's dance marks the place the Snidgets are hidden. And serendipitously, I believe that I know the very place.
Please, go on.
I have seen that symbol only once, on a rock face in the cliffs of the forest. You should make haste there. The Snidgets that have been kept there for so many years may no longer be safe.
You said you divined a series of events before our paths crossed. What were they?
I saw the arrival of a stranger, the threat of an enemy, and the return of an old friend. I believe now that you are the strangers. The poachers are the enemy, and the old friends are the Snidgets. I also saw two places tied to these events: the cave with the moonstone and the henge. The latter was bathed in moonlight.
What makes you so sure the symbol is where the Snidgets are?
I do not know. It is what I have read in the stars. Fortunes play out as they are intended. I am merely a messenger. I shall say that fortune favors us today. That you would show me a symbol whose provenance I recognize is not coincidence, but fate.
If you're right about this place, then we should make our way there.
I shall see you there. We cannot afford to lose the Snidgets once again.
I got here as soon as I could.
Did you see the symbol above the entrance? It's the one the Mooncalfs made at the henge. Of course Doran implied as much, but to see it up there...
Could this actually be where the Snidgets are hidden?
Let's find out. Doran's waiting for us just up ahead.
I'm ready if you are.
I'm glad we seem to be a step ahead of the poachers.
It is a little strange we haven't heard anything from them.
If we're lucky, they're still poring over Gran's research. There was a fair amount. We, on the other hand, had Doran to guide us. Even if the poachers do somehow stumble upon this place, we shall be long gone.
Greetings.
I hope we haven't kept you waiting long, Doran.
Not at all. Then again, it is not I who awaits your arrival. Do you have the Moonstone with you?
We do.
Good. It is as important to what happens next as both of you are.
So, what does happen next? What are these pillars here?
A safeguard, I suspect. There is only one way to find out. And as for how to go about that, the two of you may know better than anyone.
Accio! Now here's a sad-looking place.
Did it! Look, Doran, a doorway!
I suspect we all know what lies beyond that passage. And now, I'm afraid I will leave you.
Look at the murals on the wall. They're all creatures. This place must have been built to protect them. They had nothing to fear.
What makes you say that?
The poacher camps always felt oppressive. It's hard to explain, but the feeling was palpable. At least to me. The sense I get here is of safety and calm. Quite the opposite of the poacher camps. Confringo! This isn't the dead end it seems to be, but how to get through? Accio! Look at this place.
Little puppy sweeting. Forgot how to cover your track.
What was that?
Not Doran. That's for certain.
Stop right there!
Are the two of you unharmed? I had hoped to return before it was too late.
We're fine, but if you hadn't got here when you did, I led them here, Doran.
You fought with us against your kind. I am glad to have witnessed this. I now believe all that Doran told me.
They are the ones I saw, Alec.
Finish your work here, brother. All the events you divined have not yet come to pass. Now, all that remains is to break the charm.
You want us to... I only ever wanted to see them safe, which they are. You should do it. Now. They can't care for themselves, and surely once word gets out of their reappearance...
No harm will come to them. The centaurs will see to that. You have my word.
Thank you, Doran, for helping us to find them and to fight for them.
It is you who deserves the merit, child. You did what the poachers would never have. Remember that. You both fought bravely today. Allow us to carry the mantle from here.
If it's all right, Doran, I think I'd like to stay behind and spend a little more time with the Snidgets.
Me as soon as possible. I received an interesting owl from Joanna Bickle about Harlow. Are you ready to finish Harlow?
I'm ready to finish Harlow once and for all. What is your plan?
I received an owl from Mrs. Bickle. She wondered if we were having any luck going after Harlow. Suggested we could gather evidence from a friend near Manor Cape.
But she warned us to stay out of it. Was rather adamant about it.
Precisely.
Harlow knows that we saved Archie, and that we rescued Mr. Rabe. The letter didn't come from Mrs. Bickle, did it?
I do not believe it did. Harlow intends to ambush us.
But now we have the upper hand. We can prepare.
We are stronger than Harlow, and he knows it. That's why he's resorting to this sort of trickery. We must go.
I don't know if we should be rushing into this.
If he thinks we are aware of his plans, he may call off the ambush. We should behave as he expects us to.
Fair point. All right, let's go.
Brilliant. Harlow's reign ends today.
Perhaps we ought to inform Officer Singer of our plans.
I already sent her an owl to let her know that we were following a lead given to us by Mrs. Bickle.
Are you concerned she might tell your mother?
Indeed she will, but so be it. I am tired of hiding it from her. My mother needs to understand that I will not be safe from the Ashwinders until everyone is. I shall pursue them until they are finished, and I think she knows that. As do you.
That I do.
Keep an eye out. Harlow is likely around here somewhere. I sense he is close.
Where is he?
I do not know. You should look around.
Shallowable children, walk right into our...
Explosion!
We were right there. You are not going to everywhere for a very long time.
Incendio. Infringo. Bim. Confringo!
You will pay for your deed!
Oh, I shall enjoy this.
You're back to the outside long enough! Incendio!
Ready to scurry back to Hogwarts?
Incendio!
As if you...
Accio! Incendio!
Hold still!
No! Petrifico, so damaged! Accio!
Expulso!
Little Nat Sione, innit? And her excruciatingly loyal companion. You two have done quite a bit of damage to my business interests. But I must gradually give you some credit. What was once a mere annoyance has become remarkably problematic. Fortunately, I pride myself on my problem-solving skills.
Reducto!
Are you sure you are up for a visitor?
Yes, Mother. I feel fine, and it will do me good to see my friend.
Very well. But do not overdo it, Natsai.
I know, Mother. It is good to see you, my friend.
I'm glad to see you're doing so well.
I am doing better than it appears. I am only here because my mother insisted, just to be safe. I was relieved when she told me that you were all right.
What on earth possessed you to do something like that?
I don't know, but What other choice did I have? You were in danger.
I'm sorry, Natty. It's my fault you got hurt.
What? No. Do not blame yourself for this. The moment that I saw Harlow aim his wand at you, well...
You did what came naturally.
I suppose it was instinct. Yes. I could not simply stand there and let you get hurt.
Then I shouldn't feel guilty?
Of course not. There was nothing that you... Oh. Oh my. I cannot believe that it took me this long to see it. He made a choice based on instinct. My father, you, my friend, are no more to blame for my injuries today than I am to blame for my father's sacrifice years ago.
From what I know of him, it seems there's a lot of your father in you.
That's very kind of you to say. I hope that you are right. This has all been a bit much, hasn't it? A battle here at Hogwarts. Everything we have done to take down Harlow and the rest of Rookwood's lot. But we have done it. Rookwood is dead, Harlow is on his way to Azkaban, and the rest of them are on the run. A few of the dregs will still be about, fighting for their lost cause. But Rookwood's enterprise has fallen apart.
Everything is safer now because of us. Because of you.
Thank you, but we make a formidable team. You, my fellow traveler, have enriched my time at Hogwarts beyond anything I could have imagined. Thank you. I believe your friendship to be one of the most important in my life. Thank you for coming to visit me. It is always good to see you.
Alohomora.
Just the person I was hoping to see.
I see Doran finally convinced you to leave the Snidgets.
If anyone can keep them out of poacher hands, it's the Centaurs. And I wanted to thank you. When the poachers ambushed us, it was nice not to face them alone.
Of course. It's the sort of thing friends do for each other, isn't it?
I suppose so. I am glad you came to Hogwarts. It's already been my best year. I wouldn't want a repeat of Horntail Hall, of course, but I did enjoy the Three Broomsticks. Had no idea how lovely it was there.
Had you never been to the Three Broomsticks?
I used to spend most of my time with Highwing, and well, I don't know how Serona feels about Hippogriffs popping in for a butterbeer. Highwing's the only one I would have gone with. Or Gran, of course.
Nothing wrong with that. Highwing's good company.
She is. Although I am beginning to see the appeal of, human friends. It was nice to talk about my parents and Gran with someone. And share Highwing.
I don't suppose you've heard anything from your parents, have you?
I haven't, but I'm perfectly fine with that.
Does your Gran know that we found the Snidgets?
I couldn't hold it in any longer. I told her everything. She was livid that I'd been anywhere near the poachers, but she confessed that she was rather envious about the Snidgets.
It has all been a pleasure, Poppy. Do try and stay out of trouble.
Don't know that I can. We've taken on poachers twice now, successfully. I rather think you've helped me develop a taste for it. And with centaurs as allies, I might actually go looking for trouble. You and I should meet for a butterbeer soon. Perhaps Highwing can join us?
Revelio. Professor Weasley, you wanted to see me.
I did. We haven't had a chance to speak since I know you were quite close with Professor Fig.
Hogwarts won't be the same without him.
No, it won't. But I can assure you that he would want us to press on, and that he would rest easy knowing that the future of the wizarding world is in hands like yours.
Thank you, Professor.
You've had quite a year, both inside and outside of Hogwarts. I've heard all sorts of rumors. You've ridden a graphorn, befriended a goblin, rescued hippogriffs. Even helped Mr. Ollivander track down a family wand.
How did you...
It's harder to keep secrets around here than one might suspect. I'm just glad you found such a good friend in Miss Sweeting. It's nice to see her engaging more with her classmates. There have evidently been Snidget sightings in the area lately. If the centaurs are to be believed, 2 Hogwarts students are behind it.
I'm certain I don't know what...
No need to discuss it further. What I would like to discuss is your wizard's field guide. May I see it?
Of course.
What do you think, Professor?
I think you've been busy this year. I see some progress here, but quite a bit of your field guide has yet to be completed. Fortunately, you do have some time to prepare for your OWLs. I will confess, I had a sense about you from that first moment you came bursting in, late, to the sorting ceremony. I am pleased to see that my instincts were correct. To think you've only been with us a year and you'll already be taking your OWLs, well, it's nothing short of astonishing.
Thank you, Professor, for everything.
You are most welcome. I look forward to seeing what you do during the rest of your time with us.